Okay, guys, so we did the first part of interview, then this is the second part of interview which we are going to talk about. So in this part we are going to talk about few things. The objective, what is group discussion and its purpose. As I showed you in the previous, there are different types of interviews. So in this we are going to do different type of interviews. So what is group discussion and its purpose? Second type is group discussion. Panel interviews, video interviews, telephonic interviews, and in the last, things you need to remember before going for the interview, right? These are the things. So first thing, what is group discussion and what is the purpose? Very important. See, you need to understand, you need to understand that why HR take interviews. This is very important. Okay, see, for example, there are around 100 to 1000 applications for the interview in the company, and the HR don't want to waste that much of time by taking everybody's one-to-one interview. So that's why they do group discussion, right? So number of participants is 4 to 10 in group discussion. And before that, I must tell you that what is the purpose? Purpose is, if the interviewer is going to take your one-on-one face-to-face interviews, before that he or she is taking your group discussion, right? He or she is checking, the first thing that he or she is checking, will you be able to speak in the interview or not? If you are not able to speak, then there is no point that person should call you for the interview. The first and the most important, that will you be able to speak or not? Then comes the leadership skills, or are you able to, you know, generate more and more ideas? Are you able to contemplate? Are you going to, you know, control the group or not? These are secondary things. But first thing is, are you able to speak or not? Number of members, 4 to 10, it depends on what is the strength of students who are coming for the interview. If the number of students are 20, 30, then 4 to 5 number of people in the group, and 10, 15 is the number of students who are participation are 1000, 800 or 700. So they want to, you know, gauge everyone like in a hurry, and groups are made into 10 to 15. Now when we start in the interview, what are the things that are important? This is one of the materials thing that you should have when we go for the GD. I'll tell the reason also, that as a notebook and a pen, notepad and a pen, it can be there, but don't have a page. Like for example, in this slide, as you can see, you're sitting. Right, you can sit. It is also a possibility that you don't have a table. There is a table here, right? It is also a possibility that you don't have a table there. Then where are you going to put your, for example, if you take a page instead of notebook, so where are you going to put your page? You'll not be able to write. So always have a padded book or a notepad so that you can write on that. Very important. Why is important? Because when the interviewer, the invigilator, in this GD is called invigilator, right? So when the invigilator gives you a topic, that person always give you around 5 minutes or 2 or 3 minutes to prepare. So in that 5 to 4 or 3 minutes, what you're going to do, you're going to write bullet points, that what do you know about the topic. What do you know about the topic means, when that person gives you a topic, there's always for and against to the topic. For means that you are with the situation. For example, I'll give you a very simple example, that invigilator gives a topic that, should women be given reservation in private jobs or not? So when you are in favor of this, then you will go for the topic. When you are against to this, you are go against the topic, right? So if you are for, write for, and then write bullet points. Don't write stories. Lot of people, what they do, they try to write stories on the notepad so that they can read when they are, you know, speaking. But when you are speaking, you are not supposed to read. You can only have a look and then talk. Invigilator cuts your point if you keep on reading from the notepad, right? Now, for or against, you can write both for or against. For example, I'll tell you the transformation you can have for and against. But write, if you have for for, write again, write the topics in bullet points, in for or against in bullet points, right? Then, for example, sitting position is there, same as interview, as I mentioned in the previous video, that how you should fit. There should be a stout position. Like, for example, in GD, you should always sit like, you should have a distance from, for example, you are sitting like, you should have a one hand distance from the back chair. Why? Because when you have to talk to the other person, you should look excited, not over excited, but you should you should almost on the edge, not on the almost edge, but on a, you know, 50 to 60% edge of the chair. You look excited, you will be able to talk, you will be able to interact, right? So I'll also give you an example that how should we talk. Sitting position is this, and when the invigilator starts the GD, lot of people, they don't have the knowledge about the topic, right? So, and for those people who have the knowledge, there are two different advantages that they can take. There are two different, those who have the knowledge, those who don't have the knowledge. So those who have the knowledge about the topic, they take the first mover advantage, the fourth point, first mover advantage. The fourth point, first mover advantage, like first mover advantage against the second mover advantage. First mover advantage is when you speak first. When the invigilator gives you a topic, you start speaking. That is called the first mover advantage. It gives you a point. But if you don't know about the topic, then what you going to do? Some people take a bad seat and, okay, I don't know the topic. How am I going to see it? How I'm going to speak? Then you have the chance to take the second mover advantage. In second mover advantage, what you going to do is, when the other people are speaking, for example, a topic comes like Brexit. I understand not many people know about Brexit, but one or two people in the group must be knowing. So they will take the first mover advantage. And now what you will be doing, you are having that notepad, you will be writing their points and making points out of their points. See, because if you are not going to speak, surely you are not going to get selected. But if you want to speak by taking points from the first mover advantage, the person who had taken first mover advantage, you can have a second mover advantage. When that person is going to finish, you are going to start speaking by taking his or her points. You are going to write down on that paper, right? Now, what are the other things? See, there are number of ways. See, for example, eye contact is very important. See, when we are sitting, when we are giving a GD, you have to have that imagination that you are the team leader and you are addressing your team members. So when you are a team leader and you are addressing your team member, are you going to look at one person? No. You are going to have a eye contact with everyone because you are trying to explain that thing with everyone. So in GD also, you should have a eye contact with everyone. Is a tendency. It is a tendency that if you have eye contact with everyone, they will also have eye contact with you. A lot of people say that GD mein there is one, you know, one team leader, but it's not like that. There is no team leader. People evolve as a team leader, right? In these eye contact things, you should smile, right? You should, for example, if somebody is not talking, you should always initiate that person. You should always initiate. Okay, you must be having some point. You must be having some point. So you can initiate when you are finished talking. And one thing very important, that a lot of people think that one person is speaking. He is speaking for 2-3 minutes. It's okay. I'll sit and, you know, relax. But no, you are also there for the selection. So don't let that person talk for more than 1 minute. Now, a lot of people say that, How to stop those? How to stop those people? Right? There's a way of doing it. Whenever a person speaks, there's always a pause in between, 1 or 2 second pause. Right? So in that pause, for example, the person is speaking, I have to interrupt. So what I'm going to say? Does it, for example, he has or she has taken a pause. Excuse me, you have a very good point, but I also have a point, then start speaking. Then start speaking. Right? Then also, if he's not, you know, stop speaking, again, on that pause, just say, very good, my friend. I coincide with your point, but I also have a point, let me speak. Right? Let others speak. If you'll say others speak, they will also get along with you. Right? So that team building happens and that person will have to stay quiet. Then you start speaking. Right? Okay. A very important thing which people don't give much stress in GD, and that is, this is one of the, you know, a technique that is used when you're not able to speak that much in GD. For example, a lot of people are speaking, you are not able to speak, time is going on, 5 minutes are over, only 1 minute is left, you don't have much time to speak, then a very important technique that comes into hand is called conclusion. Now, how to give a proper conclusion? That is very important. How to give a proper conclusion? So, proper conclusion, you have a notepad in your hand. See how important this notepad and pen is. You have a notepad in your pen. You see people are telling the points for, and people are also telling the points for against. So, what you're going to do, you're going to write for. For example, this is the page, this is for, this is against, write those points here in bullets, which has been, you know, told by the different people who are in for, against, here, the points which have been told by the students in against the topic. So now you have you have around four topics here, four points here, four points. So now, how to start giving the conclusion? If you think that interview is getting over and you have to start, you have to give the conclusion as you have not said that much of things. So, okay guys, so you have to start like this. Okay guys, I think we should come down to the conclusion. So according to me, the conclusion for the topic is, like, for example, people are in for, repeat those topics. People who are in for against, repeat those topics. Right, and there's always, there can be 1 to 2 conclusions. It's not that there's only one conclusion. For example, you have seen that other have given a conclusion, you are left, then you can give a different conclusion also. Okay, moving on to the next slide. Group discussion, body language, as I've already mentioned, stout movement of hand, not that much of movement of hand. Don't hit the other person sitting beside you, like that is not appropriate. Lot of people get excited. Okay, stop. They say never. They you know, have these hand gestures, right, to stop that person. But no, you always keep your hands on your laps, or you can move it like this. Okay, directing your views means what I said, that for example, if you have a point, very good sir, you can appreciate the person for that. It shows leadership. Leadership is very important point, which will make you, you know, which will give you points, right? Next, panel interview, very important. Nowadays, HRs are moving towards panel interviews. The basic difference between a panel interview and the face-to-face interview is number of people. If the number of people is more than one, then it's called a panel interview. 2 people, 3 people, 4 people, 5 people, then it's called a panel interview. So, what are the things in panel interview? As you said, when the number of interviews are more than one, right? Now, when I was talking about that eye contact, why eye contact is very important, this plays also a very important part in panel interview. I'll give you an example. There was this interview going on. There were 7 people who are sitting, right? and there was a the job is for the profile for marketing, right? So this person, what he did, that he maintained the eye contact with everyone, and there was this operation person who was sitting at the last, for example, leftmost side of the table, and he was making eye contact, he or she was making eye contact with everyone. In panel interview, your head should be like a viper. You should, you know, talk to everyone. It is not important that if that particular person asked you a question, you should answer that person. You should talk to everyone. So in that interview, what happened? The marketing guy asked this question to this interviewee, but he answered that question to everyone. And there was this operation person who was sitting at the last. If he wouldn't have, you know, eye contact with him, he would have got distracted. But the interviewer would have got distracted, and he would have started playing with the phone and all that. Whenever the interviewer starts fidgeting with their phone or something like file, this means that they are not paying attention to you. Or maybe they are paying attention to you, but not 100% or 70% or 60%, only 30-40%. So that guy maintained eye contact with everyone. And the initial package was 8 lakhs, but he got a package of 20 lakhs from operations because of the eye contact. Because that person started listening to him or her because of the eye contact. That's why eye contact is very important, okay? Like a viper. Contact with everyone. Okay, stress conflict situation check. See, in this type of situation, what happens is, two or three people will try to, you know, make you in a stressful situation. That person will ask you something else. That person will ask you something else in the same opinion. What you should do to avoid stress questions like this, stay to your first point. For example, if someone said that, okay, you like this. The other person, I think if you are going to get in this company, I don't think you should like this. But then you said, yes, I like this to the other person. I think, yeah, I should not like this. But no, you should always stick to your original answer. If you're going to deviate, they are trying to check, are you have a fluctuating nature or are you focused in one direction only? So the best formula to that is stick to your original answer, right? Panel interview etiquette, which is there, like etiquettes are simple. Sitting arrangement is same as face-to-face interviews. Stout position, hands on your laps, right? Eye contact is important, as I told you. Have a light, nice grin. Tell me about yourself with the same, having eye contact with everyone. All these are the same as face-to-face interviews. Not much different except from eye contact and sticking on your original position, right? Okay. So, the next is video interview. Why video interviews are, you know, happening? You have to understand it. Why they are happening? See, nowadays every company is converting into MNCs, and they are already MNCs. They have headquarters, for example, offices in different part of India or in the world. So, for example, I am in Hyderabad and my interview in US. So people are not going to invest on my flight, in my traveling. So what they do a video interview, simple as that. Video interview is just like a face-to-face interview, but there's a twist to it, there's a difference to it in terms of etiquette, in terms of sitting position, in terms of different things. I'll explain you what are the different things. Reason behind taking video interviews, I already told you, like because they're trying to save the cost. And time is also very important, because that person is going to take time to come here, but the interview is scheduled today only. So they take video interviews, choosing the right surrounding. Okay, you are sitting at your home, right? So it is very important that you should maintain a proper decorum in the background, that there should be no noise, everything should be placed properly, there is no cloth, or there should be no food behind. There should not, the background should be very clean. Okay, and the next thing is equipments work properly. You should check priorly that the Wi-Fi is working properly, keyboard is working properly, the camera is working properly, right? You should be able to detect, like, for example, do a trial version. like a trial version beforehand, so you should able to know that everything is working properly, because it gives a very bad image that, okay, in between an interview, your sound is not, you know, going, passing through, and it gives a very bad impression, and it irritates the HR also, because they don't have time, that much of time. They have allotted time to you, and you have to complete the interview in that time only. Dressing up for video interviews. See, a lot of people, they say that dressing sense is very important, obviously, because the upper part of your body is visible. So you should have a proper, you know, dressing style, a proper shirt. If you want to wear a tie, and it is obviously very important. You should, you know, brush up your hair very properly, wash your face, and you should look clean from the upper part, because the upper part is always visible, right? Video interview. Last thing, very important. Why? Because what we do generally. We do interview, like video interview, on a laptop, and the camera for the laptop is at the top, or when we do it on a PC, the camera is at the top, right? But when we do the video interview, we look on the screen. Like, for example, I'm recording, right? So what I'm gonna, if I'll do like this, for example, screen is here, so I'm gonna look here, so it looks very awkward. So if you are having the video interview, look at the lens. It will make it look that you are having an eye contact with the interviewer. Very important. Just remember it. It's very important. Telephonic interview, same as face-to-face interview, but reason, right? Reason, what is the reason? Because they don't have time. They don't want you to travel. They don't have that much of space, or say they do a telephonic interview, and it takes a very lot less time also to take this telephonic interview. Okay, so choosing the right environment, because when you are talking, it is very necessary that there should be no background noises, there should be no disturbance, there should be somebody is crying, or baby is crying, or someone is telling you to get something, nothing like that, right? So choose the right environment. Voice clarity, always have a clear voice. A lot of people, what they do, they start hello, your voice is not audible, but don't do like that. If the voice is not audible, just say, sir, as sir or ma'am, your voice is not audible, can I call you back in 2 minutes, or you can call me back in 2 minutes. Don't start doing it, your voice is not coming, you are wasting your time and irritating the HR. Just cut the phone, ask politely, and cut the phone and call again, or you can ask to call the HR again. So what to when the signals are bad? As I already told you, signals are bad, just request that person to call you back in, or you can call back in. Listen to the whole question first. With very important, lot of people, what they do, I'll talk about this in active listening, very important. What people, what they do is, they don't listen to the whole question and answer and interrupt in between and start answering the question, because they're very excited, because they think, okay, I know this word, I should start reacting to the question. So don't react, listen to the whole question and then answer, because maybe you will be right, or maybe you're wrong. So, but you cannot take the chances, okay? And after that, when the conversation ends, say thank you sir for contacting me, and if you have any feedback or something like that, that's it. Okay, things you need to remember before going for an interview. Like, for example, as I told you, there also was, you should know about the company. Very important thing, right? Companies, headquarters. You should know the company's HQs. Very important. When you are going for example, when the question will come, what do you know about the company? Company's headquarters. Very important, right? CEO of the company. Chief Executive Officer, right? You should know the name. Founder of the company, very important. Year of foundation, very important. Turnover of the company. Okay, I'll tell you in a very short way that what is the turnover and the profit. Don't confuse turnover with the profit. Turnover is the total in and out sales that you are doing. Input, output, that is called turnover. Maybe your turnover is 20 crores, but your profit is 2 lakhs. So don't confuse with turnover and profit, okay? Share price. If the company is listed as an IPO, always try to you know, remember the share price of the company for a particular company that are going. Why I'm telling this? Because the person, the HR, will be amazed that you know this much about the company, and he or she will be very impressed, right? Know your profile for the, as I already mentioned, KRA, key responsibility area, job description, which is provided by the HR or by the college. Ask for it so that you're able to match your skills to the requirement of the company. Make changes according to the above requirement. For example, if you are making your resume and if you are making your tell me about yourself answer, you should be able to match it from the KRA and job description. Very important. This step is, you know, making you more closer towards the sure shot selection in the interview, right? Important tips: think like an interviewer. So this is a very important tip that I'm giving you. When you are trying to answer the question, think like an interviewer. What he or she must be needing as an answer, right? See, we have a lot of, you know, introspection, a lot of expectation from us that we should give this answer, he will be impressed. No, nothing like that. Think like an interviewer. You'll be able to answer the question in a much better way. Think like an interviewer. Think about it. Maintain attitude balance. Don't show negative attitude. Lot of HRs have told me that students have very negative attitudes because, for example, they are lazy, they are not, you know, concentrating enough, they are slouching on the chair. So these are negative attitudes. Don't show this attitude. Have a positive attitude. Be attentive. Be active. Be on the spot on the interview. Right? Don't interrupt the interviews. Don't try to interrupt the interviews. Maybe he or she can interrupt, but don't interrupt the interview. Let him complete his or her question. Don't interrupt. If you don't know the answer to the question, what to do? Very important. A lot of students ask me that. What should we say when we don't know the interview? When we don't know the question? So the general answer to is this. Sir, at this point of time, sir or ma'am, if you don't know the question, sir, at this point of time, I don't know the answer, but I'll definitely get back to you. I will definitely get back to you on this. Maybe you will get back to him or her or not. Maybe you will or not. It doesn't matter. But this is the way. Sir, at this point of time, I don't know the answer. I'm not getting the answer, but I'll definitely get back to you. Right? And okay. That's it, and thank you, and I hope that you are getting some of the tips that are there for the interview, and I love to hear from you. Comment below and we'll answer to you. Yeah, thank you guys, and have a great future.